Hi teachers, I'm Sarah from InkNote and welcome to the ClassPoint channel. This video today is all about how to use Google Meet and ClassPoint together for your online virtual learning classes. If you haven't already, don't forget to number one, hit subscribe, and number two, turn on those notifications so that you can stay updated when we release another ClassPoint related video or an EdTech tip or trick. Using ClassPoint in addition to your online teaching with Google Meet is not very difficult. We just want to make sure that you guys have all the best tips and tricks so that it's smooth sailing for you when you do start your teaching with Google Meet and ClassPoint. So of course it's a little bit easier if you do have dual monitors or two screens to work with, but in this video today, everything we do can be done on just one screen. So we can go ahead and start a new meeting here. And I do have two students already joined in. And the first thing that we want to do is open up our PowerPoint so that my students can follow along. So if we go into PowerPoint here, we have an example file pulled up and I'm going to present with window mode. That way I can minimize it and split my screen. And this is important because when you're in Google Meet and you want to share your screen, you must share your whole entire screen. So I know a lot of teachers do like to share a window or a tab, but to have access to all ClassPoint's capabilities with Google Meet, you have to share your entire screen. So when we go ahead and do that, then we can minimize the Google Meet tab as well and have a split screen view here of the PowerPoint and my students. So I can also pull up the chat and be able to follow along with that. And in addition, ClassPoint will continue to have all of its functions work, and we can start up a question here, and my students will be able to hear my voice as well as the ClassPoint music if you do turn that on. If you are having issues with your students not being able to hear the ClassPoint music or another video, you can let us know in the comments or check out the video that we have linked in the description on how to change up your audio settings so that will work. So let's go ahead now and check out the student side so that you can see that they are able to follow along and see both the PowerPoint side and the Google Meet because you are sharing both on your whole desktop. So we also want our students to go to classpoint.app and follow along and submit their responses when we have a question open. So just like the teacher, let's separate these two tabs and we can minimize them so that way our students can have ClassPoint pulled up with classpoint.app and submit any responses that they have, and they can follow along with what's on the teacher side if they make any annotations or do any whiteboarding and see their responses submitted live. So back on that teacher side, we can see that our students have submitted some answers. We can close the submission, we can save them, and you'll see that all the other functions of the ClassPoint toolbar still do work. So we have the laser, we have a pen if you need to write any more notes on screen, and you can continue to go through and use all of ClassPoint's capabilities, their different question types, including the competition mode. If you guys have any questions on any of the other ClassPoint features, we have a whole tutorial playlist on most of the features, in addition to another video on online teaching with different video platforms. So if you're not using Google Meet and you want to check out that, you can go ahead. It's linked up above and in the description below. Thank you guys so much for tuning into this video today on a quick little blurb about the best ways to use Google Meet and ClassPoint together in your classroom. If you haven't already, remember, don't forget to hit subscribe and turn on those notifications. That way you'll be one of the first people to know when we release a new video, and hopefully it can help update and transform your classroom. Happy interactive teaching. I'll see you guys next time.